Hello, hello, hello.
Hello.
Been a while, huh? Good to see everybody. Don't let me forget this, Sid. All right, just great to be back out there. It was nice and humid today. A little different than yesterday. Yesterday was nice and cool. Today we got a little heat. We got a lot of work done. We've had a bunch of work done since we've last visited with you guys and gals, and happy to be back here doing it. So with that, I'll just open it up.
You've got obviously a couple new faces from the defensive side, just with the draft and everything.
Yep.
Can you kind of give us a little bit of an overview? And
run down on all the guys? They're all young. They don't know anything right now. So obviously asking about Felix. We haven't seen a lot on him because he's been dinged up a little bit, so it's hard to tell. We've had Chamari out there. He's slowly progressing. He made a really good play today. Nick Jones, right? Nick's playing some nickel for us, fittingly. He's done some good things coming from a smaller school, Ball State, right? BJ is one. I know I'm going to miss one, but BJ Thompson. But BJ's been really impressive. He's done some good things. He's a young, raw guy. We knew that going in. He stuck out today, made a play. And who's my fifth?
DeAndre.
Yeah, DeAndre, KC. I call him KC. Great job, you know, but just an energetic, passionate guy. You know, reminds me a lot of Colin Saunders, really. Same body type, and hopefully he can be the same kind of player. So that's a little bit of a wrap-up on those five draft picks. And then we got some other younger guys out there running around. Listen, you guys have asked this before and been through it. There's a huge amount of volume thrown at him right now. Justin Reed went through it last year. The vets that come in go through it, and it takes a little while. We don't take that to the game. And all these young guys are kind of spinning and floating, but a little bit of smoothing out now. We went through, you know, phase one, just meetings. Phase two, we were doing walkthroughs. Then we get them out there going against our offense, and, you know, they're spinning. But we got through practice six today, so hopefully it's starting to smooth out a little bit.
Question on two players. How does Amenihu and then Tranquil fit in the mix for you, you think, this year?
FAU, Amenihu, Charles. Now, you know what I get messed up on? The Felix last name, the Charles. I'm with you. Okay, Charles and Drew. Look, they're doing a great job. They're terrific. Both those guys are pros, real intelligent football players, really happy with what they've done to this point and where they're at. I'm glad we got them. I just think both of those guys elevate their positions, and I think that gives us a lot. We'll see how we work them all in. It's going to take a little while for that. But right now, from what I've seen, Drew's made a lot of plays. For a lineman in these pack practices, you know, we can't finish. You know, you got to stay away from the quarterback, and they pull up. So it's a little bit tougher to tell there. But love the way both those guys operate.
When you throw all this stuff at him, you have the rookies all together at the beginning. So when they get around the veterans, it changes for them. Have you seen, generally speaking, what you'd like to see from that transition from inundating them with stuff and kind of going along the learning process?
Yeah, each guy is different, right? So they came in the rookie mini camp, and now we stayed very basic there because they were going against the offense. And where it started to pile up for them was they were home a week, I think. They went home a week, then they came back, and they were 1 week of phase two. And we were, like, we didn't slow down the veterans group. We didn't go back and slow down for them. They just had to pick right up. So they've been playing catch-up from the beginning. And each guy's different. You know, some of the guys stand out, and they're really sharp. Other guys, it takes a little while. But I do think, for the most part, it smooths out for these. You know what? When it typically smooths out is when they make that first really good play, right? They get a little bit of confidence. Like, I saw Chamari make that today. I'm hoping that translate to him, get a little bit more confidence. These guys, more than anything, when they come in here, gaining confidence is huge. It's huge.
When it comes to edge rushers, you guys, since you've been here, brought in a number of guys late in the game, whether it's Terrell Suggs or Melvin Ingram or last year, Carlos Dunlap. I know that's Brett's deal, but if this is your group, if this is who you go into the season with, you feel pretty good about that bunch?
Yeah, right now. Now, listen, I still got to see. We know what George has been here, right? Mike Dana. We know. We don't know Charles. I mean, we know what he didn't say. We don't know Felix, right? Way too early on that. Now, Malik Herring and Josh Kando, I really, really am hopeful for those two guys to surface. They've been here for a while. They know what we're doing. But, you know, it's up to them to take that next step. And both of those guys, I think, have done a really good job to this point. Those are the six I think we're talking about, right? But you're right. We thank God for Brett in the last few years we've been able to. Carlos, I think we got early, right? Some training camp or something. And I'm sure we would try to do that again either way. Maybe I guess the hope is that we don't have to, right? That would be a good problem to have.
Coach, when you look at your second-year DBs, like Brian, Jalen, and Joshua, how much more comfortable do they look now than they did this time a year ago?
You can just ask them, and Trent included, right? The five of them, NJ, is out there doing a great job. Now, I sat with them and was somewhere with them a week ago, and they're like light years ahead. And they feel it, and it's different, and they're confident. The first day we went out there for a walkthrough, the communication and the talk. Now, I'm including Justin Reed in that because last year was all new for him, too, even though he was a vet. The system was new. And those guys just, from a verbal and being kind of tied into that standpoint, they were just gelling.
Coach, it looks like you have Nick Jones and Boodle working the inside right now. Yeah. When it comes to top guys, I know they're not working, but do you anticipate McDuffie being that guy for you this year?
Yeah, I mean, I think that we would never give up on always having Trent and LJ ready to play in there. I don't think that'll change. Love for another guy to surface, you know, so that when we want to keep LJ and Trent outside, somebody can go in there. Whether that happens or not, I don't know. If that doesn't happen, then one of those two will be in there, and a little bit will be depending on who we're playing and what the matchups are. But both those guys can play in there, and we're trying to find another one.
Coach, you saw how Justin Reed worked with Juan Thornhill last year. Just from your perspective, how has he been with Brian Cook this time around?
Yeah, terrific. You know, Brian's one of those guys that he's a bold, vocal guy. You know, even last year, I know he was kind of the third safety and kind of rolled in there on dime. But as a young guy a year ago, I was impressed with how bold he was. Some of these guys come in, and some of these young guys are going through it right now, and they're in a position where they got to communicate, and they don't want to make a mistake, right? So they whisper it, you know, they don't hear. But the guys that will blurt it out loud and proud, whether they're wrong or whether they're right, I like those guys. B. Cook was like that last year, and he's kind of just carried that into this year. Those guys are working pretty good together.
Thanks, Coach.
All right. Appreciate it.